So we want to start announcing what they're going to be doing. So I'm going to bring over our mystery ingredients, the final two competitors, to see who will become the craft champion. Is Abby from Crafty Corner and Britt and Lynn from Two at a Time Designs. Yay! Everybody's coming back on. Everybody's taking breaks for dinner, so they're coming on kind of last minute, straggling in here. We're going to do some giveaways. We're going to talk more about vinyl, the Cricut, the die cutting machine debate. We're going to push that time off a little bit. But let's go ahead and go through. There's some challenge items in here for the true cropped champion. Are we ready?
Yes.
Bring it on, she says. Okay, so I'm going to open up this fun. I have two of the bags here, and they have many different items. Here are extra papers that you guys may use. You can set it on that table. This is a Christmas theme home decor project, and we are going to be giving them two shadow boxes from SEI, and they are awesome. They each get one. They can put it together and use it as a shadow box. They can use it in any way they choose to use it. You can use as much or as little of the project, the products that are included for their project. And I'm going to open up one of these bags, ladies, so give me 1 minute. We have a brand new cardstock that just premiered at CHA that is awesome. And it is called Twist and Tube from Worldwind Papers, and this is a really awesome material. I'm going to be talking to you guys a little bit more about this. So you ladies each have a red and a green sheet for Christmas. You must use both. You have bubble wrap.
Awesome.
Bubble wrap, because we do all the wrapping for Christmas and we need to keep things safe. There are some red sickles. You have gold embroidery floss. You have assorted puzzle pieces. Assorted candies from Craftwork Cards. Candies has been a fabulous sponsor of Bumblebee Studio and Craft Event. And also red and green Megan Elizabeth alphabet stickers. You have 1 hour to complete this challenge. I will hand this over to you, Abby. This one to you, Britton. And your time starts now! And they're off! And they are off! So we're going to start their timer. 1 hour, their time starts, 1 hour. And they can use all of the products on that initial table. They can use punches, tools, they can use the Cricut, they can use anything else that they would like to use. It's really about the Christmas theme. Now the really cool thing about the shadow box is I made one just a little bit ago. This is coming in the very last kit that I put together. I will not be doing kits anymore. Going forward, October will be the last one. There is a special deal right now at craftycorner.com on the buttons kit that I've been working with most of the day. And once they are gone, they are gone. There is a limited number of supply. We had been selling out for a while, and things are just kind of, we're changing directions a little bit. And I do not want to be putting together kits any longer, but I'm still going to be doing videos and everything just the same. And this is one of the shadow boxes I made. The kit that the theme of the kit that we're coming out with is more about mustaches and men and the masculine feel. And so I took the shadow box, put it together really, really quickly. It just pops together. It has adhesive strips already on it. I do recommend using a little bit more, like a hot glue gun or just something a little bit more to really keep it in place, like for the long haul. But it does stick really well. I lined it with some of the paper in the kit. I used just some miscellaneous pieces around the house. I used Viva Decor pearl pens in the bronze color to match everything together, because these bronze brads that are right there, they came in the kit, and they're from, I believe, Bow Bunny. And we cut up some paper, and I'm going to show you guys a little bit more of the things coming in this kit. You can see the little mustache there that I cut out. And we have a lot of other stuff coming. In Britain, I think we're using a little bit with it just a little bit ago. We're using the man kit. I call it the man kit.
Yeah, that paper when I was trying to unsuccessfully cut that baby with the man kit.
Oh, you used the man kit for that. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys just a few things that I created with the man kit. Some of the items that are included. One of the things that I created, and I will show you guys a video on at some point in time, is this scrapbook layout. And this was a scrapbook layout done in 5 minutes or less, and it was a challenge to myself. You did get a strip of this really cool muslin material. what is it called? Like, Taylor's tape or whatever it is. Is that Taylor's? Like, Taylor tape measure? Do you know what I'm trying to say? There are the wood die cut shapes of the bicycle, which is very vintagey classic. Awesome. There's also the hello, is it Hello There Handsome title tag, which is really, really cute. We did just different strips of paper, and I showed you a really cool technique in the video that you guys will have to watch later. Well, maybe you don't have to watch it later. I'll show you. For these two strips of paper here, it's actually the packaging on the rest of the paper. So I used the sheet of this wood grain that you saw me use for that shadow box, for the shadow box here. I used this paper, but I cut out this bottom packaging. It's the reverse side of this paper. So I cut that out and then used it on there. And that is this paper. So this is some of the paper included in that final man kit, and that's going to be released in October. It is the only time it's going to be available. Once it's gone, it's gone. But look, we totally did the trend. So the final kit, the buttons kit, has the chevrons, the hexagons, the bright colors that I'm really into, finishing up your summertime layout that has some fruity things, it has sparkle lights in it. And then this is kind of wrapping it out. This is the man. This is the masculine. This is kind of rounding everything off. It does come with this shadow box. So you do get the shadow box included that you can decorate any way you want, just the front. I left the back blank because I felt like I liked that width there. But you can make it, you know, totally coated. You can ink it. You can paint it. Anything you want to do with it at all. This is the number one favorite paper that's in this new man kit. And this is the mustache sheet. It's from Times and Seasons from Echo Park, and this is the reverse side, which you do not have to use for a man. It's a very wonderful neutral theme that you can do a lot with. The same as this wood grain. You know, that reverse side being the stripes is really phenomenal. There are a lot of other papers included. I only have a few here, but I am going to show you. Here is another different kind of wood grain, a little bit more of a broad pattern going the other way, and the reverse side of that is this really great red checker. The checker print is very popular as well. There is the card sheet. So if you look on here, I cut out two of the cards, the record player and the bingo card there. Cut them both out for on my shadow box. And there's a lot of different options there. And I also used the tags here, these little like ticket stubs, as one of the embellishments on my scrapbook layout that I did. And then the reverse side is that old-fashioned journal ledger. All right, and those are just a few of the things that are in there. There's also, Britton was showing the plaid and the red polka dot, red dot paper that's included, and there's a lot of other good stuff in there. So like I said, there's the wood shape, there's a whole packet of sparkle lights, you get a whole packet of the brown, wrap me in chocolate, Megan Elizabeth stickers, you get a assorted brass brads, like different brads just like those that I used right there. You also receive some twine. This is one of my favorite things that's included. You get a decent chunk of this muslin, like I said, the tape measure, which is really great. So, ready? Okay, now we're going to take a look over and see how the ladies are putting together their boxes and what they're working on right now. So we're going to switch camera angles, and I'm going to, there's Cassandra doing a little bit of work there. And we're going to take a look at Abby. She is putting together her box right now. She seems like she cut it up, but she didn't have the outer frame. That's for her. And she's not working on it as a shadow box anymore. She's turning it into something totally different. So we'll see what Abby creates with that. And Britton's over there. She's working on the paper. She's using some paper from Authentique. They are also a sponsor for this event. Some random sheets of Authentique paper will be inserted. They were included in your mystery box, in some of the mystery boxes. Random mystery boxes already got Authentique paper in it, and we also are giving them randomly away in some of the, when I say there's a mystery prize or two in some of these bags, you never know what those mystery prizes are going to be. It could be a rhinestone adhesive sheet, it could be snazzy tape, it could be both, it could be a Megan Elizabeth ink edger, it could be anything. So we have a little bit of everything being put in. And it looks like Britton's making some kind of star shape. I'm not really sure what she's going to create. And she's shaking her head no. So I'm not really sure what she's creating right now. But she is going at it. And we'll see. Oh, Cassandra thinks it's a Christmas tree. Oh, and she's shaking her head yes. So she's making a Christmas tree right now. Great job, Cassandra. Hey, Cassandra, can we take a look at what you're working on? Cassandra's doing her own scrapbook layout right now, so we're going to come over and take a look. She is using some glitter and some scotch tape, some buttons. I see a little sheet of the rhinestone, the cuttable rhinestone sheets that are available right now. She has a really great picture of herself, and she did great color coordination. This is the snazzy tape, right? So she has some snazzy tape on there. You can see the nice broad snazzy tape. The yellow looks great with her shirt, and the yellow rhinestones are perfect. Everything is really popping out and coming together for Cassandra's perfect scrapbook layout, and she's doing circles, too. Were you trying to do circles for our challenge? You are? That's great. She's shaking her head yes. I know you can't see her. All right, so everybody's over there working. You can see the Cricut machines going in the background over there. We're going to be having the die-cutting machine debate. We have the Cameo, the eCraft, the Cricut Expression 2, the Mini, the regular expression, all coming up next. We just have a lot of things happening, and it's intense in here. Everybody is so focused on exactly what they're doing. I'll leave this camera set up right here so you guys can keep, we can keep checking in on our pros. Start checking in. All right, so I wanted to give you guys a heads up about the Crafty Corner promotions that are going on for craftevents.com. In case you missed it, yesterday we did announce, let me switch back here. We did announce a really great deal, and it is a bundle deal on the chipboard stickers, and it includes the green, the pink, the orange, the brown, and the blue. And it is the incredible value. It is a $17.99 value, all four bundled together for $8.99 on craftecorner.com right now. We also just created a Crafty Corner logo on vinyl that we're going to be doing. We're going to hang that up so you guys can see how we mess around with these. So for Crafty Corner, we also are doing a special deal on the buttons kit that I've been talking about and showing. If you want to get that glitter paper and you want to get some of the things we talked about, like sparkle lights and, oh, there's also ink edgers included in the man kit. There's so much stuff. There are special prices on that, as well as the scrapbooking attitude. So those are all special event prices going on right now at craftycorner.com. And there is also a coupon code for 10% off your entire order. That does not include, however, the items already on sale. So, for example, the bundle, the scrapbooking attitude, and the buttons kit are going to be excluded because we did special pricing on those just for the event. And there's also a coupon code just for the event, 10% off the rest of your purchases. So a Cricut cartridge, other adhesive, anything else that you want to buy. They have now over 50,000 products in store. Correct, Carrie? I think 40,000 products is a lot of scrapbooking supplies, ladies, and you can get 10% off with your order for the weekend. It's a great time to take advantage of that as well. The coupon code is CROFT,
capital letters,
all capital letters, 2012 for CROFT. Corner.com. Non-sale items, and this is all non-sale items. Okay? Alright, so let's go ahead and take a look. We have a lot more to talk about with the vinyl. We are running behind schedule a little bit, but everything's going to be recorded. We're working on all the recording so that you guys can not miss a thing. So here is more of the square one vinyl, and you can just see it prints colors brilliantly. You can print photos on it. You can do anything at all that you want with it. A link for square one is on aboverbystudio.com, and this is not regular vinyl. It is adhesive fabric. It is a woven material. It's completely PVC free, so that's why it's not really called vinyl. It works like vinyl, but it's better. It feels like fabric, but it has a completely non-damaging adhesive on the back that you can stick it on your walls, and it will not cause problems. So I've been using this one all day, peeling it off and sticking it back on, I'm going to stick it over here.
Okay.
And you can see it's not losing its stick at all. You can stick it on cell phones, on laptops, on anything that you would want to decorate with something that you cut out or something that you print out. So custom photos. The sky's the limit. And they come on 8.5 by 11 sheets for the printable. And then there are bigger sheets available for the already pre-printed colors. And you can see Sean is kind of messing with that right now.
This is fun. I just cut out a bunch of flower shapes and all kinds of colors.
So she just cut these out. And this is the colored vinyl from the new Halloween collection.
And,
Yep.
So now I'm just kind of throwing them up here and layering them. And, oh, I think Megan's head might be blocking.
Hold on one second. Hold on one second.
Okay. We'll do that again.
Hold on. Can everyone see us okay? Can you just give us a yes if you guys can see what we're doing, if you can hear me? We just want to double check really quick. Anybody that's here? Anybody? Okay, good. They're seeing us. We're good.
Okay, all right. So let's say this is in my daughter's room and she loves flowers. But today she likes it like this. And tomorrow she decides she wants to rearrange them and pull them off. And
they peel off from on top of each other as well.
And line them up in a straight row, more like a border. Then she could do that. And then, you know, she wants, 2 days later, she's like, no, I'm over that.
She can make them in the shape of her initials.
I want to layer them again.
Yep.
This would be so cool in a child's room. I could totally see cutting out the alphabet for a border.
Yep.
But then as they start to get older, you can go, hey, look, C-A-T spells cat.
Yeah, and start spelling out words like we did for my son Benson.
Right.
We can do all of that using this really, really great adhesive fabric. Now, it's not just for on walls, but it's really great for wall art because you can print your photos on there and do photo collages. You can do them for hospital rooms. You can do them for, there are so many limitless possibilities for classrooms, things that you cannot normally hang things up in. It's a very versatile product.
And my mother works at a school, and they have a lot of brick walls.
Yep.
And she's like, we can't hang stuff, or if we do, we're taping it up, and then the sign falls down.
Falling right down.
And then the sign tears anyway, so we end up throwing it away. She's like, if we could print it out on this.
And it doesn't, I mean, eventually it will lose its stick. Let's be honest.
After
but
56.
56, exactly. I have done at least 26 with the picture of my daughter Genevieve and I that you can see at aboveRubyStudio.com. It is something that I did post as a Fresh Look Friday probably a year ago. I got started with Square One Vinyl right out of the gate. And it is totally printable in your inkjet printers, totally repositionable, and it is a fabric that's completely kid safe. It's totally PVC free. So there's a lot of great benefits to this, a lot.
The printable that we use to do
the printable,
the Megan Elizabeth and the Crafty Corner,
yep.
This is on sale right now.
It is on sale right now.
I believe almost 20% off. Don't quote me on
okay,
that.
Okay, we're gonna. You guys can go check it out. There is a link posted on craftevent.com under our event sponsors, and there is an event being posted, a link being posted here. I think Courtney just posted it, and there are. There's also a link at aboveRubyStudio.com. So go check it out. Get in on the sale so that you can get it. It's a little bit of a complicated link,
right,
to get directly to the product.
But, you know, even, okay, now your child is out of this phase of flowers, don't throw them away or like wallpaper where you have to tear it down
and
it's just
and trash. You're done? No.
Start
decorating your scrapbooking supplies. So let's grab a few.
Oh my gosh, that's a great idea.
Oh yeah, I decorate my scrapbooking supplies all the time. I can print out things and they don't just have to go on walls. Now, I have done them on paper already because it's such a unique look. So you stick it on there, and you have a really cute flower that is great. It's just awesome.
Oh, Megan, look, you can even stick it on metal.
You can stick it right on metal or aluminum. It works on so many different things. It works on brick. It works on stucco. It works on your, quote-unquote, non-stick surfaces very easily.
And then it just comes right back
off. It comes right back off, and you can restick it up to 50 times. So the link is posted under the event sponsors. It's Square One repositionable fabric, and you're going to love it. You can also decorate like your gypsy case. So I have a big cricket head on there. Say I really just don't want this cricket head to be seen anymore. I can put a flower right over top of this silicone, and guess what? It's sticking to silicone, ladies. So where are our silly sheets? Where are our silly cuts?
Oh my gosh,
it's
yeah.
sticking. This is sticking right to our silly cut
you
sheet.
You said that, and here. I didn't believe it.
It cuts with scissors. I used a paper punch earlier today.
It's sticking on there. So I don't know what voodoo magic is in this. Thank you so much. Here's our silicone sheet. I'm going to stick this on there.
It's stuck.
It is stuck, and it's not peeling off.
Yay!
So.
Oh, my God.
And it peels back off. But it is stuck on there, so you can decorate your scrapbook layout, and this is just an awesome product. Wow, I'm excited that it sticks to silly sheets. I
didn't
realize it when I stuck it on there. Like, yeah, it really does stick to
awesome.
That. Because I have stuck it on there before. Okay, so you can just see how many times you can do that. So, does anybody feel frustrated when they're cutting out vinyl? Does anybody feel afraid or intimidated of vinyl in any way? I want to know in the polls, who is scared of vinyl? I'm going to post a poll right now, and we are going to do a giveaway based off of this participation as well. So let me, I'm scared of it. I use it all the time. Need to learn how. It's okay. I want to know. So we're starting the poll right now. So it's pretty darn exciting. So it works the same way as vinyl, but it's not vinyl. It is a fabric. Making it completely clear for everybody. All right. I have my Swedish fish with me today, and I'm going to eat too while you guys are answering the poll question. Yeah. Okay, let's go over and check out Abby's ink technique. Let's see what she did. We're going to check that out real quick. Abby's creating written stuff on at the boxes here.
So, I have used her ink edges on every single project so far. And I needed her a couple
wraps. So, you talk a little louder.
So, I used her green.
Oh, you know what? I'm gonna just talk for you because I can see that this is not going to happen. Okay, so what Abby is saying, I see what she did, so I'm going to explain it and she can interrupt me. But she has been using the Megan Elizabeth ink edgers on every single project that she is working on. And she had to use bubble wrap in some way, shape, or form. And what she did is ink up the bubble wrap and she used it as a background stamp on her box that she is creating. So you can see how she's doing that right now. So that's really, really awesome technique. You can have fun doing that. All right. So we have a lot of weigh-ins on this poll here. Thank you. And we have 45% saying, I need to learn how to use vinyl. So we want to show you, and we want to show you that it's really a very simple thing that you don't have to be intimidated by at all. One of the first things I'm going to, I guess, show you guys about vinyl and about cutting it is settings are so easy, and that's your key. Kissed cut settings are really what you kind of want to go for. And if you're, what a kissed cut is a sheet of vinyl comes on a backing carrier sheet. You want to cut through the vinyl without cutting through the backing. And there really is nothing any different about cutting it out than cutting out your paper. So in order to get kissed cut, it's all about your settings with your machine. So for example, with the Cricut Expression, I'm going to pull up my iPhone, and there's 38 minutes remaining on the challenge. We're going to go to, I have a scrapbooking section on my phone, and there is a Cricut cutting guide on here. If you click on the Cricut cutting guide, and the Cricut cutting guide is available as a free download on AboveRubyStudio.com, or you can purchase a bound version of it. They just got back in stock at AboveRubyStudio.com, and I believe CraftyCorner.com has a few in stock. What you can do is from this search menu here, you can either use the sidebar on your smartphone or use the search and type in vinyl. And you can see there is glitter vinyl. Glitter vinyl is a little bit thicker. Or there's regular vinyl. And vinyl, this adhesive fabric, it's exactly the same way. And there are settings for cutting all the way through or for kissed cutting. And this is in all of them. I'm just showing you from my phone because it's the easiest. Just click on the kissed cut setting. And then you're going to select whether you're doing a basic shape or an intricate shape. And normally when you're doing any kind of vinyl cutting, you're doing something a little more intricate, like words or phrases. You know, you're not always, you know, she'll cut up the flowers, so she did a more basic shape there. But you just click on what you're doing, and I'm going to do intricate. And you can see right there, it says vinyl kiss cut. And you're going to use, for an intricate shape, less than 1 inch in size or intricate, you're going to use your regular blade. You do not need a deep cut blade. The blade depth is going to be set to 3. The pressure is going to be set on 2, and the speed is going to be set to 1. I always go with a really slow speed when I'm cutting vinyl. If you are in using your Cameo, there is actually already a setting pre-selected for cutting vinyl, and it's the same when you're cutting with the Cricut Expression 2. There is a pre-setting, for cutting vinyl, and you can select that from the menus when you go to actually cut out your material. You don't have to do anything special. All you do is place your carrier sheet down on your cutting mat. And we're going to bring over a die cutting machine in a little bit. Sean's actually going to bring a die cutting machine over. And we're going to test cut some vinyl so you guys can see just how easy it is. But all you do is you place your sheet down on your cutting mat just like you would any piece of paper. Face up, you don't have to flip it when you're doing something like this fabric or regular vinyl. You can do colored. Sean's been working with the colored square one fabric that is already colored to a variety of shades, and you don't have to print it out if you don't want to be messing with printing out your own colors. You can use this in the Cricut Imagine. I use this particular product in my Cricut A to Z DVD, and I also used it in my Christmas Crafts DVD as well. So you just place it right on down. You load it in. You make sure you use these settings, once again, that I showed you from the Cricut Cutting Guide. Once you have those settings in, you select any image that you want, and you cut it out just like that. So, Sean's bringing it over right now. We're doing a great thing here. Do you mind bringing it over? I know. I'm asking so much.
No, you're not.
Oh, let's just set that up there.
Okay.
Show exactly how to cut it.
And I'm going to show them how to use my stick and spray from Crafter's Companion as well. Okay?
You got a cartridge in there?
Can I get a sheet of colored
paper?
Just a scrap of something new we're using is fine. It doesn't have to be a whole new one. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys. This cutting mat is losing its stick a little bit. I'm losing my voice while it's losing its stick. So we're a good team. But you can see, I mean, it has some stick to it, but it's kind of like falling off my hand a little bit. It's doing really good. We re-stuck it a little bit just using a little bit of the stick and spray. Now, if you want to truly refurbish the mat, start to finish, go check out the video at abovereviewstudio.com. Right next to the Crafter's Companion link, it's on the special discounts and deals. There's a great offer on this, 20% off your entire order. So you can get all the Spectrum Noir markers, you can get the stick and spray, the stick away, you can get any of it. 20% off, and it's right now. So you're going to shake it up a little bit, and you're just going to spray right on to where you need it to be re-sticky. Re-sticky? Re-stuck? Refurbished? Where you need it to be sticky again. Okay, so we're going to put the lid back on, and we are going to stick this down. I'm gonna switch overhead so you guys can see once again. All right, I'm going to stick this down just normal, just like paper, okay? Nothing fancy about this. This is a fabric, and we're going to pull up our settings again. I'm going to turn on the Cricut. You do not need a deep cut blade, okay? There's no reason to have a deep cut blade. Vinyl and this adhesive fabric is very thin, all right? So we're going to load in our cutting mat, and we're going to double check our settings one more time just to be sure we have them right so everybody can see. We're going to set our blade depth to the depth of 3. We're going to select our speed, 3. We're going to select our speed to be all the way down on 1. Now, you can be a little bit more adventurous and go a little faster, but we're going to let it take its time. And we're going to set our pressure to low or 2, all right? That's where we're setting that. Let's see. What can we cut out?
let's cut out.
Do you have a font in there? You could have somebody's name just on the.
Or what you sure. You know, Sean has a really, let's see this notebook. So there's a really cute little notebook here. I love this thing. Look at this. This is like index card size that are perforated that you can then like stick into these pouches here. But you can't redecorate this like you can many other, you know, cardboard based notebooks that you could, you know, easily put adhesive on and refurbish.
It's in my way.
It's in your way. We'll move it out of your way. But you can stick this repositionable fabric on there. So we're going to move that camera for Britton real quick.
Yeah.
And let's see. Well, this is going to be for your daughter, right?
Yes, it is.
So why don't we do it for Beth?
Yes, you can.
And we're going to do it in the roly-poly setting because I love that setting. So we're hitting roly-poly from the Plant and School Book cartridge. And we're going to do B-E-T-H. And I think we can do it at 1.5 inches. Is that a good size for you?
I think that's great.
Okay. And we're just going to cut it out right on here in yellow. And then, actually, I think we'll make it a little bit Subway art-like.
Oh, that would be really fun.
Why don't we make this a little Subway art-like for us? I'm going to grab a quick drink while this is cutting out.
And then that was, doing the Subway art thing. That would be fun because she could move it around and rearrange it.
And put it on other things as well.
Well, yeah.
Put it in her room someplace else if she doesn't want a full Subway art on here. She can add a few more flowers. And we'll do it in two colors.
Or hockey sticks.
Yeah. And I might be able to speed this up a little bit, but we'll let that just go. All right. So thank you, Darlene. Yes, the cutting guide is available on the AboveRubyStudio.com website. It's also available in a booklet form, and it's also available as an iPad smartphone app in any of your stores. So you can see right here, I'm going to peel this off just so you can really see, it did not cut through this backing sheet. So if you want to do, let me just show you really quick the old school way. It's not an old school way. It's the proper way if you're going to weed and do something with vinyl for hanging it on your wall. So let me show you. I'm going to grab a paper trimmer just so I don't waste anything. I'm going to weed out my image. It's called weeding when you're working with vinyl, and I just want to make sure I don't cut into my shape. It slices and works so easily. We're going right in there. I don't want to waste anything because I can use this in so many different ways. So you want to kind of trim it out first. And then what you're going to do is you're going to peel back the negative. Now, the great thing that you can use with this negative for, and you, since it's repositionable, you may want to do that. I can't get the backing pulled off. Sorry. The great thing that you can use the negative for is for glass etching or as a stencil. You can use it for so much because it is repositionable, and that's the really cool thing. So, Sean, I'm going to let you put this on something as a stencil, but this is actually weeding. This is what weeding is. It's removing the excess vinyl. So if you've ever seen it out there, I think Britton posted the word weeding on her blog post about doing the vinyl. So you can see here is the outline of Beth, and then there are the internal pieces, and you want to make sure you remove them too. Great idea. Here, hold on a second. Hold on. Let me give you the internal pieces before you walk away.
Yep.
So we're going to give her the insides of the bee. And you can see it just cut completely smooth, but it did not cut that backing sheet in any way. So it leaves it intact for you to be able to transfer it to your wall with the letters perfectly lined up. It leaves it intact for any other thing that you may want to use it for. If you want to wait to place it on something, it's there. You're not trying to peel it off individually and line everything up. So the thing that I don't have handy is painter's tape. But what I'm going to do, because this is repositionable, is a little strip of this still. I need that paper trimmer again.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
No, that's okay.
I'm just going to use a tiny, tiny strip of this repositionable. Now, this won't normally work, but if you had transfer tape or painter's tape, this is what you would do. You would cut out your transfer tape to be the size of the letters that you're working with. And you spread it out right across. But what I'm going to do is take a tiny little strip here of the repositionable vinyl. Okay, this is not going to work with any vinyl. You cannot do this with any other vinyl. You can only do this with this repositionable fabric. Okay? Only do it with that.
And Megan, you're only doing this for a demo.
For a demo sake, just to show you how you would do it. So if you had transfer tape or blue painter's tape, you're going to cut it down and you're going to place it right over top your image. And you're going to do what's called burnishing, where you're going to make sure the fabric or the vinyl that you're working with truly is stuck down to your transfer tape. Then what you're going to do is peel it all back. And you would want it to be the full size, not this little strip. But what you're going to then do is peel it back one at a time. And the burnishing is what makes sure it's stuck on there, okay? That's why it's called burnishing. That's what that is. It's stuck to its transfer medium, whatever that medium is. And you really want to cover it the full, entire image that you're cutting out. So the letters, it doesn't matter what it is. You want to make sure it's fully burnished and fully on, and you just want to peel it back really nice and slowly. It does take a little while when you're working with this kind of medium. So my letters are now transferred, and they're perfectly lined up the way I cut them out and want them to be. So now what I can do is come down here on my project and place them down one at a time, making sure they are lined up the way I want them to be. Just like that. And then you're going to press them down really well. You're going to re-burnish it so that it's stuck down to the material you're working on. And my B has a little bubble in it, so I can peel that back, get those bubbles out, because it's repositionable, but it's still lined up. And then you're just going to want to peel it back slowly. Whatever you're working with, you're just going to want to kind of like keep it to the wall, keep it to the project, and peel it back. And there's a bubble in that H, but all we need to do is peel it up a little bit, and it's back down. So there is Beth's name right on here, ready to go. And we can cut that out several more times over. I can let Sean play with that. You can reuse the strip on something else. She can highlight her name with it. She can put it down at the bottom of the notebook here. And you don't have to waste a thing. So I hope that helps you a little bit understand a little bit more about fabric and the vinyl, the way to create with it. Now, so what Sean just did is she took, is this the backing carrier sheet?
Yep.
She took the backing carrier sheet, the reverse side, the non...
Oh, no, this is just a piece of white cardstock. I stuck the negative...
Okay, misunderstood.
No, yeah.
What Sean did was took that negative that I showed you, she put it on some white cardstock, she placed in the little letters, and she used Megan Elizabeth ink edgers to go in there and just ink up, like just like a stencil, just on white cardstock. And it's white cardstock, remember. So if you're trying to stick something to white cardstock, what's going to peel off of that easily? Okay?
Square one vinyl or
square one fabric is really going to be the only thing that you're going to get to peel off this easily. And she can reuse this stencil for Beth's name over again. Now I'm getting ink all over me because the ink is not dry.
Well, yeah. But I know, we didn't let the ink dry, but yeah. It's so exciting, we couldn't wait.
Yep.
Okay.
So, you got to be still and let the ink dry sometimes.
Yes, and we didn't.
But we did. But you can see, if you were still and let the ink dry, you wouldn't see my fingerprints. This is a square one fabric, but it's the same thing as vinyl and how it works, but works better because it's totally repositionable, and you can stick it right to this white cardstock here.
It's like an alternative.
There is her name done in ink. All right. All right, nope, there is still a little bit of time left. The participants now have, let's see. Let's double check our time here. Whoops.
Oh, there we go.
They have 20 minutes and 30 seconds remaining. 20 minutes and 30 seconds remaining. So that's really cool. All right, I got to get this ink off my fingers, but that's all right. Oh. Here we go. I'm going to give this all back to Sean. She's going to take that away. So does that help you guys feel a little bit less intimidated? Does that help you guys feel a little less intimidated when it comes to... Oh, hey, thanks. Okay. Woo! Okay, so another product from CHA I'm going to show you guys because this is really awesome. I'm going to remoderate Darlene real quick. And thank you, Darlene. I'm glad I helped you guys a little bit. This is called Grime Boss, and this is like industrial strength cleaning wipes for your hands. But it works on all your inks and so many different things. They really kind of didn't market it for us crafty ladies too well. But I'm telling you what, it is a crazy cool product. Tim Holtz does use it. You just rip it apart. It comes in individual wipes, but I rip it apart. And it has a little bit of a texture to it, and it cleans your surfaces, but mostly, most importantly, it cleans all the ink off your hands. So that's the more important part, is cleaning us up. When you forget to let the ink dry, or you have, yeah, different things on there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, Carla, the Cricut vinyl and many other vinyls are not repositionable. Standard vinyl, it's a one-time use. That's why this Square One is such a unique and wonderful product. It is a very different product, and that's why we are sharing it with you guys and showing you how to use it. But you can use the same technique from the standpoint of you can cut out vinyl the same way. But it will not act as a stencil on white cardstock. It will not repeal off your wall several times over and restick. You may have a little bit of resticky room. Most vinyls do not stick well to brick and to stuccos and to different kinds of textures. Most vinyls you cannot print on easily. And vinyls have PVC in them. And the Square One woven fabric, repositionable fabric, is totally PVC free and safe for kids. If you want it on a mug, will it stay on? I don't think it'll wash well, but it will stay on the mug, and you can reposition it after washing. The thing that you can do with it is if you hand wash it, it may work, but we'd have to check the color. So I have not actually tested it. I know I have stuck it on, I have a travel mug, and I had stuck it on the inside of my travel mug before, and that worked really, really well.
People have stuck it on the back of their car, on car windows.
Car windows, it does work.
So, and the other great thing about it is that you
why
don't.
Let me come over here and talk for a second. I'm having a little bit of a coughing fit, so I'll be right back, you guys. I just want to get a little bit of water.
And Megan did a great job of showing you how to use transfer tape, but you know that again is just when you're using your typical vinyls with the Square One. You don't even need the transfer tape. When I used other vinyls, I was always running around. Where is my painter's tape? I can't find it, and messing with that. So this. Even intricate little things will peel right off, and I like that it doesn't stretch and distort. I was showing some other ladies, and even paper punches, we were punching out different things. So it's really great. Anybody have any questions about that I could try to answer? Oh, no, it sounds like somebody had someone spelling out not good words with their letters. Ooh, yeah, that's not good. I don't really know how to.
Wow.
Yeah, I guess that is something that could happen. Where do you buy Grime Boss? Where do I buy Grime Boss? Probably at Crafty Corner?
No. Really, they were marketing those for car uses and men, and then they were trying to figure out how to get into the craft industry, so we've yet to find them.
So they're not really in the craft. So they probably are at, like, the hardware, Ace Hardware's and the Menards and the, yeah, check your
local auto
stores or Google Grime Boss, and I'm sure you can find somebody that sells it. Oh, Amazon, good idea. And Walmart has them, somebody says. Maybe Auto Parts Store. Yeah, that would be my guess, too. Is it time for a challenge? Oh, yeah. You know what? Let's do that. Let's check in on what those people are making. Oh, there's only 18 minutes left.
18 minutes.
18. And Abby's not even at her station.
She's at the Cricut, though.
Okay. I don't have to switch the camera. Otherwise, I would switch the camera so you could see them and not me. But really, Abby's nowhere to be found. So, and Brittany's over there busting her butt, but I don't know where Abby is, so maybe she threw in the towel and decided to crop herself out. Is she having the same kind of, like, I tried the Cricut issues I was having with the last time? That was my downfall. I didn't know the art philosophy cartridge very well, so For the pros to finish their challenge. What? Oh.
What's that?
Oh, people said 18 minutes for what? And I said for the pros to.
Oh. Hi.
Very cute.
So I'm sucking on a lifesaver for a minute.
But she smells minty fresh.
Minty fresh breath that is sure to last. Hey, Carly, could you do a favor and just comment real quick for me so I can re-add you? Pep Boys, Costco, Walmart. Ooh, oh, it all carries the Grime Boss. Yeah. Very cool.
I'm sitting here playing with it.
It kind of smells good, too.
Yeah.
We're nice and close here.
Yeah, no, we're all snuggled up.
All right, we're making...
We're like snuggly puppies. What? Hi, John from Beth. Oh, that's my daughter. Hi, honey.
So any miscellaneous projects that you guys are working on or people that are participating in group challenges, I look like a chipmunk with this stuck in the side of my cheek. You can upload to Project Gallery Challenge Number 5. Challenge Number 5 will not be announced till tomorrow at around, oh, what time? We are announcing that, oh, almost right away. We're announcing that at 2:30 Eastern Time tomorrow. That's when we're announcing Challenge Number 5, your final challenge for the event. And the challenge winner is going to receive a Cricut Mini with 3 cartridges of their choice, which is awesome. Very awesome. The sale at for Square One, when you use the link, it should be 20% off.
I think it is. Don't quote me, but...
It may only be 15.
I just remember
we did not get a final. It is on sale. Go through that link, and you will be able to see it.
Oh, I can tell them a secret.
Secret, secret. She's okay. Got a secret.
You guys keep a secret?
They're not going to keep anything a secret.
You guys keep a secret? It's just between you and me
530 and 500 other people.
Yeah, just...
Only 530 of you.
I'm working on a new glow-in-the-dark Square One.
We're not supposed to tell them that.
Oh, I thought we could tell them.
We're going to be in trouble. I signed an NDA saying I wouldn't say anything about... I signed an NDA saying I wouldn't say anything about any kind of glow-in-the-dark vinyl.
Wouldn't that be cool for Halloween? You could cut
out the letters
at Happy Halloween and stick it on your garage door.
I know. I could see cutting out little, like, cat eyes.
Oh, my God.
And sticking them on your car. Or so, like, glow and
on the window so it looks like...
Yeah, so what are some of the things that you guys would use glow-in-the-dark adhesive fabric for?
Stars for the ceiling.
Stars for the ceiling.
And you could rearrange them to be constellations. And, oh, no.
I'm not even going to ask what your favorite constellation is. Ooh, on a pumpkin? That would be so cute. So cute.
Instead of putting a candle in a
Cassandra had a great idea of cutting out the shape of your jack-o'-lantern, but then sticking a sheet of the adhesive fabric on the inside, the glow-in-the-dark fabric on the inside, so it glows in there. Ooh! That's awesome. Oh, we have another scrapbook layout completed by Carrie, which is crazy. She's, like, banging these things out and making me a little bit,
that's
like...
all even.
But look how cute this is! Water room fun at the Children's Museum. You want to tell us more about it?
Yeah, so the kids love to go to the Appleton Children's Museum, and they have a great splash room where they can put on their raincoats and just play in water. You know, they love to do it during bath time, but so much more fun while they're all dressed up and have their friends around. So, hanging out and splashing around.
It's awesome! What's question about Crafty Corner. Can you apply several discounts to your order? If so, how? The answer is no, you cannot. Sale items as well are not included with your discount code, okay, for this event. So we're sorry about that, but that is the way that they kind of do things, and that's the way the system is set up. But yeah, next question. Time for a giveaway, and they are absolutely beyond correct. We are time for a giveaway, and I don't have somebody watching my giveaway slots right now, so.
But I will.
Thank you. Carrie's going to be here to help. And we are going to be taking a break in one more hour for another 15 minutes. And let's see, we have.
You have an out of the bag.
We, let's do the, two crafters companion and an out of the bag. Oh, we're giving away a Cricut Mini today.
Is that today?
We're giving away a Cricut Mini today, too, but that's not until after we talk about the die cutting machines. I'm sorry, this is in my mouth. I'm gonna swallow it. I'm sorry.
The Hershey's one?
Okay, so we're going to start with the items in this bag. I'm good, thank you. The items that are in this bag are a Cricut magazine. There's some vinyl projects in here. We have the Faber-Castell Mix and Matched Media Kit in blue, and it comes with a stamp. We also have a LeBlanc stamp, one of the LeBlanc stamps that we're giving away. We have a few other goodies in there, and I'm also going to include a printable sheet of the Square One repositionable fabric, but I have to find it. That's going to be included all in this giveaway. And we're going to randomly select somebody from the bag. By the end of this weekend, I'll be saying bag more and more.
Oh my goodness, there's so many names in
there. There are so many names in there. And the winner is Gina Wiseman of Ohio. Wait, is it Gina?
Could be Gina.
It might be Gianna, but it's from Ohio. So, yay! Yes. Brittany is missing her stickers from her challenge. They have 11 minutes left.
11 minutes? That went fast.
Yeah. Okay. So congratulations, Gina. I need to get a sheet of.
Let me grab that really quick. Grab that Square One vinyl.
Fabric is going right in there. I just don't want to miss it. Okay, we have the magnetic storage system. She won the Square One vinyl and several other really fun things. Or fabric. Now I'm saying it.
I know. It's so much like
it is a vinyl.
Yep. So it is.
Okay, we have winner Lori Fletcher from Wisconsin. And her name was picked right out. We're gonna pick the magnetic storage system. Wait on that. Right there. For now. Okay. I can go on that one. We'll have to get it because we have one that we can give you, and then we have
Picking another one for the Spectrum Noir markers.
Are going to Sarah Klatka from Connecticut. Sarah Klatka, are you here? Let's see. We have Sarah going on this one. Let me break that down real quick. Okay. We have another, we're going to do two more real quick. We're going to do the magnetic storage system and another stick and spray set from Crafters Companion. We have so many Crafters Companion giveaways. Crazy. We use random.org to pick challenge winners. This is Dawn Schaefer, we'll say, from Louisiana. Dawn from Louisiana, you won the stick and spray set from Crafters Companion. Yep.
We're trying. I see all those ladies staying for about one. Pick up. There's so many in here.
There are.
I can't get them separated.
We'll get it. This is Phyllis Worley from Arkansas. Phyllis, you won the magnetic storage system from Crafter's Companion. That's awesome. So, Phyllis.
All right, more giveaways later.
Yep, we have a few more giveaways later. We still have
the Cricut Mini, the participant giveaway.
Well, we have a participation giveaway that we should do right now since they're all here and active. So, we're going to do that now.
Bring it over.
We got Sarah.
Nope, got it.
Okay. Now, since really quick.
Remind them participation.
Lori?
What does that mean?
Okay. Lori, since you are here, I'm going to ask you to come over. Lori is here, so she is a live participant, and we're going to give her the option. I'm not going to let her see, but she's going to get the option of having either the Crafter's Companion set sent to her, or she gets the surprise of whatever items are in this bag to take away, and the name of the random participant will get the other thing. So it is up to Lori, since she is here in person with us. You can either know that you're getting Crafter's Companion, or be surprised.
Door one or door two.
Let's make deal. You didn't know you were going to do that.
Was it the marker?
The Crafter's Companion is the stick and spray and the stick away to refurbish your cutting mats and to use the repositionable adhesive.
I'll go throw them away.
She's going to take the surprise bag. Are you ready to see what you've won?
Yes.
Can I show everybody on camera?
Go ahead, sure.
Do you mind?
No.
Okay. Do you want to be the one to show them?
No.
Okay. She won the Elizabeth Karchner Cricket Magazine. Or Northridge Magazine, not Cricket. I'm sorry, Elizabeth Karchner, Northridge Magazine, the Paper Crafts Magazine.
Cool.
Yay. She won one of the sheets of the rhinestone adhesive material.
Oh, baby.
She won a Megan Elizabeth stamp set.
Cool.
I got one.
She won.
Oh my goodness.
A Westcott scissor holster.
Wow. I'm gonna be the queen.
She won the entire collection of Megan Elizabeth ink edgers. All 10 colors. All 10 colors. And some of these bags are going to be including all 10 colors too, but I'm not telling everybody this. So a lot of these bags that we're giving away, when I'm saying there's other prizes in there, you're going to be surprised when you come up. Everyone has different. So don't contact us saying, I didn't have any ink edgers. It's not because of that. Everyone is different. We're just giving some different surprises. I don't want to tell anybody what everything is in every bag.
Thank you.
So, those are some of your things, and you have a button in there and a few candies and embellishments as well.
Thank you.
So that is your participation giveaway, and we're going to select one other person to win what you had initially won.
Thank you.
Congratulations!
Yay!
Yay!
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Sarah from Connecticut just walked in, came in. She was out on a walk and walked in and found out she won.
Woohoo! Yay! That's awesome.
And then somebody said the gift bag. They like the bags where to get them.
Those are little yellow bicycle,
and they donated them for this event. They were donated from Smith. So I just need to give this one away.
Yep.
We can set those aside for later. So this was what Lori had initially won. She won the Crafter's Companion stick and spray. But because she was here and we were doing a participation giveaway, we allowed her to choose whether she wanted what was in the bag, whatever it was, or the Crafter's Companion set. So Lori already took her gift with her. Time check. We don't have much time left. They have 4 minutes and 45 seconds, so just under 5 minutes. All right, so let's do a quick giveaway here. So the winner of this is going to be somebody that lets me know the answer to this question. Person number, Cassandra, give me a number between 1 and 11, please.
She's saying it?
Nope, just a number between 1 and 11.
5.
Number 5. So the fifth person to answer the question, is any vinyl repositionable and able to stick to itself? Fifth person to answer that correctly will receive the stick and spray and stick away. So, 1, not all, 2, not all, 3, not all, 4, not all, 5, not all is to Morgan. Uh-oh, hold on. I gotta pause it. It goes to, I lost my chat is now screwed up. Yep, I'm trying. It's Morgan somebody, and I gotta see. Morgan DR? Morgan DR was the fifth person to answer. No, it cannot. Thank you for that participation. And Morgan, we're going to have one of our moderators contact you to get your email address so we can make sure we send you your prize. Okay, there are 3 minutes left for the pros to complete their shadow box using Christmas theme.
Are you doing that?
Okay. Sean, go ahead. I'm going to let Sean contact you, Morgan. She's going to get your email address, Sean, can you write it right on this, please? Thanks.
All right.
Yeah, if you would like. Okay, we're just keeping track of everybody. We don't want anybody to not get their giveaways. There are so many things happening. We still have a Cricut Mini to give away tonight. We still have die cutting machines to talk about. We still have 2 hours and 10 minutes remaining total for the night.
Yeah, we're going to talk about die cutting machines. We have the name of Victor.
Yep.
In the challenge.
2 minutes.
2 minutes remaining.
Wow.
So we're running a little bit behind schedule with some hiccups, but that's okay. And we're going to take one more break at 7:30 Eastern time while we switch out some die cutting machines and talk about some different things, okay? So yeah, the actual square one is not officially vinyl. It is a fabric, totally PVC free. It's awesome. Okay, we are going to be talking about the die cutting machines between 7 p.m. and 8:30 p.m. with a 15-minute break in between Eastern Standard Time, okay? Right. Okay, let's switch camera views. Let's see what they're finally working on. All right. We see Carrie. Carrie's checking it out there. Carrie, what do you see? What's going on over there? Can you report to us what you're seeing?
We're at 1 minute left.
Yeah.
Counting, and they're just making sure.
The paper's flying everywhere.
They're making sure that they have used all of the items that they were given to make sure that they're eligible to win. They are at 45 seconds. Until the end. Oh, Sharon Sparkle! Sharon,
oh wow, that's cool. At the last good minute. Sportsmanship.
35 seconds.
Oh man, we're at 30 seconds, guys. This is not a lot of time, and that glitter is not going to be dry.
Oh, using.
No, but does it have to be?
Using the bubble wrap as a craft element.
We're using it for inking and stamping backgrounds, which is pretty awesome. I think Britton is having some fun creating. I don't know that she wants to admit it right now because I'm making her do it in a time crunch. But I think she's having a little bit of fun creating.
I don't know what you're talking about. 2 seconds, 1 second,
hands up. Woo! All right, that is our final. Ladies, please bring your project forward. Judges, we're going to have you guys come forward. All right. They're coming forward now. We're getting the poll ready. There we go. You guys are good. All right. So we're going to start with Abby's. She's going to place her forward here on this table. Or you can hold it up and show it in this camera since it's a little bit larger. It's up to you.
Okay.
Which do you prefer?
That's fine.
Okay.
Okay. So instead of using my shadow box as a shadow box, I wanted to take a different route. And the first thing I think of was a box is a present. And rather than use a regular present, I'm thinking of kids and toys and kind of when kids go and shake boxes under the tree to see what's in them. So I use my puzzle pieces inside of the box.
She used her puzzle pieces in the box.
And it's actually almost kind of like a game. It's called Can You Guess What I Am? And it has the puzzle pieces in it. And I used everything. So. So it's a kid's game, decoration slash. It's a little, you could put it out under the tree just for decoration, but it'll be fun for the kids too.
That's awesome. Well, we're going to set that here, and we'll get an overhead shot of it in a little bit while Britton comes over, and she tells us what she did with her shadow box.
So, mine's just a shadow box. Where's it at?
It's right here.
There you go.
It's not just a shadow box. That's what it's supposed to be.
It has a little tree, and my puzzle pieces are actually the base of the tree.
Puzzle pieces for the base.
It has a little tree made out of paper. I cut ornaments from the Artiste cartridge using that fancy twist.
The twist paper.
The twist paper. My bubble wrap I used as a stamp. And it's my letter stickers that happen to me.
Very, very cool.
Very pretty.
Okay, we're going to set it down. Did I just do that?
Yes.
Okay. All right, we're going to switch to an overhead shot so you guys can take a final look before you guys start voting. Okay, so I'm going to bring it up closer. I'm going to start the poll. This is Abby's. This is the game, the shaker game. She used her tube and twist right here on this card along with both colors of letter stickers. She used the sparkle light. The puzzle pieces are inside.
What about the bubble wrap?
She used the bubble wrap as the background stamp on her project. And then this is Britton's, where she used the twists in the tube. It makes great die cuts. It's a very thick, almost plasticky-like, really neat woven acrylic paper. She used some Cut Mates to cut out the word Noel, and she made a really cute Christmas tree that I actually did that. So this was together. When I grabbed it, I pulled it apart, so that was my fault. So judges, please do not take that into consideration. The Happy is with the alpha stickers, and then she also did different colors of ink and sparkle light, stickles on the outside edges of her actual shadow box that you would set on the shelf. And her puzzle pieces are the base, and you can see she also used the twist and tube on the inside to line her box as well. She used the floss right there for the ornaments, and as well as Abby used the floss here. So you guys can cast your final votes of who should be the cropped champion. We're going to let our judges decide as well. We're going to ask that Abby and Britton please leave the room for just a few moments here. And we're going to have some serious fun with us. Oh, I was letting you guys decide amongst yourselves.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
I thought you were reading.
I'm sorry. Okay. You guys can discuss. We had a moment of silence. We had a moment of silence for the crafting professionals. Okay. This is obviously Abby's project, so you guys can discuss what you like, what you don't like. Remember, this is the final challenge. So we really need to decide who is going to be cropped, who's going to be named champion based off of, you know, all the creativity, the criteria that is happening. So we do have our audience voting, but you guys can each write down in a circle kind of what you think.
I want to discuss
and
a little
it's
bit.
Totally. So go ahead and discuss.
This one, I like the uniqueness and all the thought that went into it. This one here.
Yeah. That it's a shaker.
Is it's not a shadow box.
It's not a shadow box. It wasn't meant. It didn't have to be remained as a shadow box.
Kind of what's unique is it is unique. Outside of the box, outside it made box. Something new.
And I think this is a little plain for the final challenge on the outside.
For the final?
Right.
Mm-hmm. A little bit more plain?
I should have dressed it up just a little bit more.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we're getting a little bit of a... Yeah, she also used the candies on the Christmas tree for the Christmas tree ornaments as well. Mm-hmm. And you can see some candies kind of decorated on here.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of a messier feel to how the glitter is placed and to how the splotches are kind of working out there. So, you know, it's kind of a judge's opinion here. Mm-hmm. I'm going to stop the voting now on the poll here. So our judges are going to make their final little decision, checking it out. So the bubble wrap, once again, I see being used is the bubble wrap being used is on the background. She inked it and then like stamped it on there. The same with Britton. They both had the same idea, and they used the bubble wrap as a background stamp inker kind of thing. So that's how they used the bubble inking. Mm-hmm. We're gonna call it bubble inking. Okay, so we want to call our ladies back in. We want to hear any other feedback that you guys have about the two challenges as well. So go ahead and start commenting to let us know. We can let our contestants know.
I like the bubble wrap. photograph inking. I might try that.
Bubble inking, new trend. It would have been cute to actually see them use the bubble wrap. I do agree to actually put the bubble wrap on, but it's in there. Yes, that was my fault.
It's bugging me.
It's mine. I know. I'm gonna have to stick it back down for her using some adhesive squares or zip dry. Okay. All right. You love the gift box idea. Would have loved to see the bubble wrap actually used in more ways than just as an anchor. We're going to switch camera views to see so that once again, we're going to let everybody know our crop champion is going to receive a gift bag full of goodies. A big gift bag full of goodies, including the Max Blue Glider Pro, which is a mamba jamba of a tool. And, wait, what did Darlene say? Thinking outside the box is a good thing to do with bubble wrap. Okay, we have some other feedback. So we're just letting our judges weigh in their final little bit here. We're pretty sure that we had a very, very close decision. The judges were almost at an exact split. And because of that, and because of everything that we're doing today, we want to do the drum roll.
Oh.
We're going to do the drum roll. Today's crop champion is going to be, look at their faces. I'm building up the anticipation. Building it up. Look at their faces.
Should we go to a commercial
break?
We're cropped. Okay, drum roll, please. Here we go. Today's crop champion is actually Britton Lynn from Yay! Two at a Time Design. So Britton received a majority of votes from our online viewing audience, as well as several votes from our judges. And Abby, you won many votes as well. It was a very close race with your creativity of thinking outside of the box. And because of that, we have a very nice little gift prize selection for you as well.
Yay!
Quick, before I go back, both were absolutely amazing.
I saw a lot of questions asking how Britton did the tree. So if we have time and she can demo it, that would be
how to actually do this tree.
Yeah, it's just strips of paper that
that I ruined.
When you have more time, you can use more glue. That's a long
one. That's a long one for sure. Yes, the debate for the die cutting machines is coming up next. Okay? So we're going to get cleaned up really quick. I'm going to switch this camera angle back for you guys. I would love to hear any other feedback that you guys have about the projects you all had seen. Britton kind of wants to, I can show you guys a little bit of how she did the strips of paper. Let's see.
You need paper?
I have some paper layers right here. I just need a
paper trimmer.
Paper trimmer. My paper trimmer keeps disappearing. So I'm going to take, I'm going to go overhead for this for you guys.
Oh, you got somebody quicker than me.
It's okay. So I'm going to go over him, and basically what she did you do different lengths or all the same?
I was in a hurry. So they're all about the same width. They were only all about an inch.
Yep.
And then I kind of cut them all the same, and then as I was going, I sort of trimmed them down a little bit. You know what I mean?
So I'm going to show you guys really quick so you guys can get a pretty good idea. Britton is really, she is the t-shirt queen. She is. So what I'm going to do is cut out 12 by 12 strips, all just over 1 inch. I'm not doing it exactly like Britton. And then I'm just going to cut them down a little bit.
Big mess.
Yeah. Britton made a mess. There's a surprise. No. We all do. We all do as crafters. So I'm cutting it down, and you can use different adhesives. I'm going to use my my glue glider here, and I'm just going to start by folding it in half. You just fold it in half, and then you bend it out. All right? And when you do that, as you're bending, you can kind of put a little bit of adhesive on there on both sides. And you grab your next piece, and you fold it in half, and you bend it out.
Okay, so you're just kind of curling the paper. And you're going to keep stacking it right on top of each other. So I'm just using my adhesive along that top edge. All right, and this may not be the exact same way Britton did it, but this is how I have made these before. So I fold it in half, place it on top, and then you trim them as you go, and you bend them out as you go. And some variety really does help when you're doing this. And then you just continue stacking it all the way up, and you create this really cute little Christmas tree look. And Britton decorated it with the he decorated it with candies as the little like Christmas ornaments there, but you got the pretty good idea of how that looks. And you just kind of, you can tape the very bottom one together for more of a base, you know, a little bit more of a base there, a little bit more flattened, and it gives you a really cool thing. All right, so everybody is getting cleaned up. We're going to start bringing over the different die cutting machines, and while they're doing that, I want to open up the Cricut Mini and show you guys pulling that right out of the box. So I know this is a really exciting thing. We're giving away a Cricut Mini tonight, and we also have one for the final challenge tomorrow. And we're going to start pulling this out. So I'm going to grab this really quick. I don't want to give you guys too much dead air time, but hold on 1 second. Okay. So while they're getting cleaned up, I'm going to show you guys opening the Cricut Mini right out of the box. I love doing box reveals. That is one of the things that on all of my DVDs, I actually try to do start to finish, exactly how it comes packaged, so you know exactly what you're getting when you open a box. And this one is still completely sealed. I have not used this machine yet. So there may be a little learning curve, or there may not be. I have found that I have found that ProvoCraft machines are very intuitive for me to use. Now, not everybody feels that way. I do not enjoy the Cricut Craft Room all that much, but I do enjoy my Gypsy more than anything else in the entire world. And I will teach you guys start to finish, A to Z, how to use your Gypsy, how to use your Cricut Expression, how to use your Cricut Expression 2 without a problem. And I really hope to do the same thing with the Cricut Mini. Now, Pat Davenport is here, and she has some things that we are excited to release and share together. And we're going to be talking about that a little bit later, but I want to keep you guys in suspense about this big reveal, because this is big news for AboveRubyStudio.com that you guys are not going to want to miss. Part of the reason why we're not doing kits any longer, we're taking a little bit of a different approach that's going to be so fun, and you guys are going to go nuts over. All right, so I just want to make sure, can everybody see the top of my Cricut Mini? Can you guys just let me know that you can see the Cricut Mini? And this is what the entire box looks like. This is the front. And you can see that this is sealed up. All right, I'm going to tilt it down just a little bit more. I'm going to show you guys exactly what the Cricut Mini comes with. So I'm going to actually slice this open. I hate to see that Cricut C disappear. I hate it. I want to keep it all together and pretty. But that is the security tape for when you buy it in the store. So we're going to open this box up, and we're going to get started. The first thing that you're going to see when you open your Cricut Mini box is the die-cutting mat. And the mat is different. It's a different size. It is 12 inches by 8 inches. So it's smaller, and it's a more unique size from the original Cricut and from the Cricut Expression or the Cricut Expression 2 or the Imagine. It's a little bit of a smaller, more manageable size for some people. So that's really cool. We're going to open it up and see that there is some pre-included paper that is ready to go, and there are detailed instructions for making your very first project included with this box as well. So that's a really awesome thing that you're going to get some pretty yellows, and I believe it's gray. So yellow and gray, my favorite color schemes in the trendy world right now. My absolute favorite is always going to be pink and teal, always, always. It has been since I was a little girl, but it's really a beautiful, trendy color scheme. When you open it up, it's a very compact, light machine. So we're just going to remove the packaging. I'm going to toss it aside. Literally toss it aside. I'm going to tilt this down so you guys can see the machine more. And we're going to open it up. So this is what the Cricut Mini looks like if you've never seen it before. And this is how it comes packaged. This is really, truly what you're getting. And we have two people this weekend walking away with one. It has not a click lid like the other machines do. It's something that slides open, and there's just a little bit of packaging, I guess you could say, in here that you're going to want to open up and pull out, okay? You just slide the arm open, and this is where your blade housing is going to go. We'll show that in just a minute or two. There is a Cricut Mini Quick Start Guide. And this guide is actually really cute. I think this is the Quick Start Guide. Let me double check. It's sealed up. I'm gonna tilt you guys back up here a little bit.
This is like Christmas morning for you.
It is Christmas morning for me because I have not gotten to play with this all the way yet. But it has this cute little closure, which I love about this. And there's several things included. So there is a welcome, a quick start. There is the download of the design software, make your first project and get inspired. And it's all right here. So you're getting artwork, you're getting additional information, everything that you need is in this fun little thing. And you also have your warranty statement. So you can pull out each individual card, one thing at a time, and this is very different for ProvoCraft. And you can have your quick start guide of everything you need for getting set up, downloading the software, each and every single thing that you need to use for this machine. So we're going to close this back up. We're going to finish opening up the box because we're going to need our power cable. Power cable. We're going to need our cutting blade. And we're going to need our power, our USB connection to our computer. I'm going to set the box aside.
Whoa!
All right, let's start by looking at how we install the blade. The blade, it comes in a little bag. We're going to push this open. The blade is already installed in this little green housing. So if you push on this top thing here, you can see the blade kind of sticks its head out. Let me show you again something else here. So you can see that that's the blade right there. Okay. All the Cricut blades currently come with the numbers 1 through 6 right on there. And it's a little twist top. All right. So we're going all the way from 1 to 6, and you can go in half increments. So if you turn it right there in that little half, you can see that's 5.5 right there. All right? There is a little arrow right there in that front, so that's how you know what setting you're on. And then there's several notches here. There's this first little notch, and then there's the second notch. This second notch here, this is where your blade housing rests when you put it into your machine. We're going to open this up to put it in the blade carriage. And you just kind of want to get it in there that you can feel it grab. You push the arm closed. And I always like to have my arrow facing directly square forward at me. Especially with the Cricut Expression, it really does seem to make a difference in how that blade handles. And I'm not sure why. We're going to tighten this little nut here. And there also are a few additional settings here. And I believe this is for raising and lowering. Let me double check. This is for, we're going to look what that's for exactly, because I have never used this before. We're just going to double check what that part is on this machine. So, it is part of the housing assembly, and it's not on the quick start, so let's see. Oh, Abby is leaving, so everybody, you want to come say bye to everybody?
Hi.
Thank you for voting. Oh, do you want
the prizes now, or can you get them later?
This is
okay, I'll have to get them for you. We'll leave them here.
Bye, everyone. Thank you.
Say bye.
Thanks for voting. Whoever voted for me.
Nice meeting you.
If I can stop by tomorrow.
All right. So what we're going to do, and I was pretty sure that it was for the pressure, but I didn't want to say it for the actual blade, how far down the blade housing went, but I wanted to make sure it wasn't for the roller bar. So I just wanted to double check in the guide because, like I said, I have not used this machine before. I'm using it first time. But there is a little, you can see there's no external dials or anything on this machine like there are on the Expression or the Baby Bug or anything else. So there's a power button and a load mat button only. That's all that's on here. So there's no speed or pressure buttons that are actually on here, but there is a little lever that helps with your pressure. So what you can do is you control your blade depth right from the little nut, the little turn level here, knob here that I just showed you when we installed. And then the final one is your pressure from this little clicky knob lever that is right here, and it goes 1 through 5. So like I said, I just wanted to verify this was for your actual carriage housing pressure, like with your Expression 2. That is what this is for. It is not for the blade roller, just for the roller bar, just for absolute certainty, because somebody actually did ask me that and I wanted to verify. So what you need to do to get started is open up the power cord, right? Now I already have Cricut Craft Room loaded onto my computer, and you guys are not going to be able to see the Cricut Craft Room working. We'll have to do some tutorials about that later. I am not the greatest fan in the world of the Cricut Craft Room, and I want to share with everyone the backing. The little back has a port for your USB cable as well as for your power cord. We're just going to plug in the power cord. Get that set up and plugged in. And I want to get my other cable working that's already plugged into my device. And let's see how well this works for me here. Alright? So we have to get the adapter ready. It should power on. Let's see. Does it power on? Very easily it powers on, and there's no there is no other cardboard or anything included in there. Alright, and there it is. So this is the little load and unload mat. You can kind of see how that works. When you use a cartridge or link cartridges, you insert it right here, right into this little port. Let me grab a cartridge really quick. Really, really, really quick.
You want to grab a cartridge?
No.
Is there one?
Here, honey.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess that's like a regular Expression, and it's not. Well.
So the cartridges get clicked in right here. All right. And I'm just going to come over and open up the Cricut Craft Room and see what we can create. So I'm going to get a project ready to go. I'm not going to use kind of what Cricut suggested. I mean, they kind of do a first project, so you can kind of see. You can kind of see the different things that it suggests. Oh, dear. To make your first project, they suggest making this little thank you that you can adhere together using the gray and the and the yellow, but we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to do something a little different here. And I'm going to, let's see. I just want to grab a basic shape. Any kind of basic shape. But I'll figure it out in 1 second. Let's see. We're going to have to do more details on how to use the Cricut Craft Room at some other point in time. Okay, we're going to use this shape here. And I'm going to make it several inches. All right. The Imagine cartridges do not work with. Oh, well, I guess they do because you can use your Cricut Craft Room. So no, they don't plug in. So you can't link it through your Mini. You have to link the cartridges differently. And I'm not exactly sure for the process on that. But yes, with using the Cricut Craft Room, you can use the Imagine cartridges as well, just the same as you could with your what is the machine? The expression two.
The expression two.
So I'm going to load in my paper. I actually already hit load, so I'm going to actually unload it just to show you. We're going to have Sue and Tanya are going to be heading out here in a minute. They are leaving several sets of silicone sheets for everyone, or silly crafts sheets for everyone who are winning different prizes. They're going in those different mystery bags. So we need a big round of applause and a thank you to them. All right. So we're going to place this mat right here. Okay. You can get a good look. It slides right in, and then we're just going to click load mat. All right. It's going to load in where it needs to go. It's going to find its markings. Okay. It's checking everything out. And we're going to press cut. Let me make sure that my pressure is correct. We should be good to rock and roll. And it's already cutting. Now, this does work with your Gypsy. It works with your Cricut craft room. And you can create anything that you want to create in a matter of minutes. And this is a much smaller machine for many of you crafters out there that don't have a lot of crafting workspace. This can go on your kitchen counter and just click right into your laptop or any other computer. So it seems to be a little bit more of a manageable machine for some, especially those who want to use the Cricut more, or rather their computers more, and get the digital cartridges and the digital content that ProvoCraft is coming out with. So we're going to unload the mat. And right here is my really large basic shape that I selected. It's more of a, it's like a frame bubble. And this is a brand new, very sticky, sticky, sticky mat. But there is our first shape. So it took minutes. We set it up, and in moments, we had it connected to either the Gypsy or the Cricut Craft Room, and we were cutting something out. All right? So you can download the Cricut Craft Room. It comes, there's step-by-step instructions included for downloading the Cricut Craft Room. If you have troubles with that, you can use your Gypsy. There is really no limit to that. All right, we want to talk about the rest of the die cutting machines. Now is the perfect time for us to take a 15-minute break, especially for those on the West Coast. We're taking a break a little bit early, and I'm hoping that is answers some questions about the really awesome Cricut Mini, that mini itty bitty little machine, and how that works. And I can't wait to be giving some of these away. So 15-minute break, everyone. We'll see you back at 7:45. Eastern Standard Time, and we're going to be talking about the machines that you see behind me here. So behind me we have, I'm going to move this box out of the way so you can see the machines I have behind me. We have the Cricut Expression 2, the Silhouette Cameo, and the eCraft by Craftwell. And we will be back in just a couple minutes. We'll see you real soon.